The next critical part of your brand building process is preparation. You need to prepare yourself for the heights that you want to climb. You must prepare yourself to find out what are the tools and materials that I need to help sharpen my giftings or my calling to become exceptionally good at that. One wise man said that become so good at what you do that the world cannot forget you. So whatever chosen field you find yourself to be, you must prepare. You must study at that. You must always constantly work at yourself, work on yourself as a creative person, molding stuff, creating things every single day. You must not stop at anything. Always working on yourself. Always there should be something you're working on. Always, every now and then. These are preparation stages. And sometimes what stops most youth or most people is that they are inherited to be in the limelight. They are inherited to be for fame and to celebrate it. But you must invest a lot of time in preparing yourself for the height you want to climb. So what are the books I need to read to polish my brand? What are the skills? What are the arts? Find out all the resources offline and online to help position yourself. When you do that and prepare yourself so well that the world can't even forget about you when you bring your product and service out. So it's preparing. And the next phase of your brand building process after preparing is positioning. I always say the world, it doesn't pay attention to generalists or jack of all trades. The world pay premium for experts, the surgeon, the lawyer. Imagine having a car, having Mercedes-Benz or the latest whatever class you can think of, and you have some fault with it, and you're driving by, see a mechanic and says, I fix all manner of cars, and this one at the opposite side says, I'm a Mercedes-Benz expert, BMW expert. Where will you drive your car to? The one who says that I can fix all manner of cars, or the one who says I can fix only BMWs? Yeah, right, we want to go for the experts. So the world pay attention to experts, and in this particular age that we find ourselves to be, the world is paying a lot of attention to what we call SME, subject matter experts. Maybe and not just someone who can even just repair cameras, but only camera lens, who can fix the lens so well. Not just somebody who can just sing, but sing certain genre of music. Not somebody who can only speak as a general public speaker, but speak on certain subjects, on leadership, on branding, on healthcare. So what is the specific niche that you need to carve for yourself? So in the position era, you need to carve a niche for yourself. Set a new category for yourself. Let me bring you some new product for you to understand. Anytime Apple brings up a new product in the system, they always want to lead a category. They don't make a product for all. They don't brand everything as Apple. They are the first to bring maybe movable or walkable phones, what they call, when they started, the iPods that you can listen to. First in that field, in phones, they bring the iPhone. Every phone, every product they bring leads a particular genre or a particular niche. So don't bring up a product and say, oh, you are doing this for all, you can do everything. As much as you are multi-talented like myself, people should know you for one specific thing, at most two or three. Don't exceed that. Don't become jack of all trades. I can do all this. It should be one product at a time that we can build expertise in that area. So find and build a niche. Niching things down in this age is very important. So what product are you bringing out? What market are you selling? What are your target audience? Kids, adults, the aged, or the old? Find, get your market well crafted. And when you close your eyes, they can think of you. When they think of a product, they can think about you, because you can feed a specific niche. Sometimes you want to bring out products and services and you want to meet the whole world. No, start with a specific niche, a specific category. What product or need are you meeting with your product and service of your brand? The last part of your brand building process, which is very essential in this age, is publicity. After purpose, preparation, position, you need publicity. From the first example I gave, they are great footballers than the Ayews and the Asians in their villages, but where they are not known. They are not in the public arena. People have not discovered them. So until you are discovered, an undiscovered journalist has no value in the marketplace. You must be discovered. Your product, people must taste and see that you have something valuable to offer the world. Let's bring a typical example locally. Let me give you an example. Let's look at Calibos. He started his career based just virtually from YouTube. churning out videos on YouTube channel, and we're discovered now ambassador of Airtel company. So the point is, what are the channels that I can find my market or I can be discovered? As an artist, you can draw so well. Why don't try it? Go to the mall one day, go start doing a standard drawing, draw people, paint for them at a goal. You get the attention, go to event, go to place where you can be discovered. You're selling products just in your house. Move around to where there's a market, is where your market is. Let them find you, let them discover you online. These are tools you can build. Do you have a website? Do you have a YouTube channel? Do you have a Facebook page? These are tools in this age using social media to promote you, your product and service. When it comes offline, what are networking events I can visit or I can attend to exhibit my works? Can I use my friends as my ambassadors to sell my products? So find all these people, all these areas. You must market your products every now and then. Market, be top of mind when you think of you or product or need or service. It should be about you, it should be about product, it should be about service. Finally, I keep saying that, why do companies like Coca-Cola keep on advertising? Because they want to become top of mind to audience and to people. So whatever you do for your brand, business and product, find ways, means to become top of mind. And when you think of product, service and need, it should be all about you. So these are the four P's to help build and position you as a brand.